if the EPA chooses to use approaches like a tradable performance standard or converting to a budget for the states and giving the states the flexibility to maybe do cap and trade on their own. 10 states already have cap and trade in place, or to do other measures flexibly. This can keep the costs down and achieve a cost-effective outcome. Basically, any of the flexible approaches bring with them, or basically are designed to achieve cost effectiveness. What I mean by cost effectiveness is that they're achieving emission reductions from the set of regulated sources at the least cost possible. So it's biggest bang for the buck. It's not what economists would describe as the best possible outcome, because it's cost effective only within the set of regulated sources. It's not cost effective for the entire economy, because there may be other ways to achieve emission reductions elsewhere in the economy that would be cheaper than doing it the way we are going to be doing it at power plants. But it's cost effective within the set of sources that are regulated, and power plants are the most important emission source that we have in the country, and where it's also where the lowest cost emission reductions are likely to be found at first. So it's promising from this standpoint.